prospect.
We do, because today you get a meet and greet with Take That Abroad. Or you might be a fella as well.
Yep. If you'd like to meet Take That, if you'd like to go to Germany, if you'd like to see them in concert, stick with this show this morning. Competition details come a little later on.
Hello. You two have been very busy today. What are you up to?
Oh, we're too busy to know all that, Andy. Come on, we're going to be
the
venue,
we can't stand around gossiping.
I mean, I'm busy as well, you know. Listen, you're going to have to entertain yourselves for a while. I've got things to do. I'll see you later, all right?
Okay.
Oh, we're on! We're on a lot!
Oh, thank you so much. So what is on this show? You said it was good. What's on it?
All this lot here.
What's
I'll tell you what it is. Look. Hugo the Troll in Aeroplane World. If you would like to play Hugo in Aeroplane World, the phone number to call comes in a few moments' time.
Stand by. Michelle Gell is our special guest all morning, but a full interview in depth at 10 minutes past 11.
I can't believe it. There is a Bugs Bunny cartoon on at 9:30. It's
Four
called
minutes.
Nightmare Hair.
Four minutes
away.
Oh, yes. Then there's a lovely lemur in the studio just after Bugs Bunny.
No.
Lemur.
Simon Fenton was on Criss Cross yesterday.
It was.
You can meet him on this show today at 9:50.
Fantastic. It's all go, you know. If you like the Animaniacs, this looks like a Mickey take of L.A. Law. It's called La La Law. It's 10:10 till we do it again.
Check it out. Are you going to do your little dance?
Yes.
The Beautiful South here at 10:45 and 11:25.
I'll carry on regardless, because Batman is here in The Worry Men. That's on at 10:50, which is 10 to 11 in black and white.
And at 11:15, if you'd like to meet Take That, go to Germany and see the concert. Make sure you're watching. Yes, I'm here.
Hello, Juicy Chill. I haven't seen him all week, you know.
No, he hasn't. I've had a very busy week this week, viewer. I have.
What's
yes.
been up to?
Well, on Monday,
yes.
I went to the Mr. Dentist man.
Get
to see about my teeth.
You never.
And I did. And then on Tuesday, I went to visit all those lovely boys down the Boy Scout hut.
I don't believe a word.
And then it's true. It's all true, I tell you. And then on Friday, I went to see a man about a car.
Get lost,
I
you!
No one did.
Has such a good week, do they?
Can I do
the rubber glove test?
Yes, you can.
Excuse me.
It's an admission of guilt not to do the rubber glove test, children. You'd best not watch.
I'm doing that with my mouth, really. See, right, here we are. Turn round. This will be one in the eye for my brother. Or one down the throat, anyway. Dental equipment. He ain't fibbing,
is
he?
I'm not fibbing.
There we are. Boy Scouts, have you had a cracking time?
I have had a cracking time.
Well, I never.
Can I do the same to you now?
Get lost? No, I'll do myself.
How was your week?
Orange, somebody chucked a brick at me on Wednesday. I won't tell you again. Was him.
You can build a bungalow now.
Good morning, Great Britain. We said Michelle Gell from EastEnders would be here all morning, so let's have our first peep at her now. Hello! Give her a cheer, kids! She's here! Woo! OK, welcome along. Now, listen, I'm a big fan of EastEnders, and what was happening a couple of weeks ago when Hattie was having a snog with Steve in that car, and all we saw was the back of your head. It wasn't your head, was it? Let me just check. Go on. Turn around. Let me see the back of your head. Look. See? That was not your head. It was a filling actress, wasn't it?
I'm sorry, it wasn't me.
I see. But he doesn't deserve you anyway, because he's a rat.
No, he's rubbish.
He is. He's a little cheater. Look, Steve, what on earth is it? I'm doing an interview with a big star.
Someone has stolen all my keys, all right?
Oh, is that all?
What do you mean, is that all? Security will be smashed and I'll lose my job. And you wouldn't want that, would you? What? Don't answer that.
Well, call the police then or something.
Good idea. Police! I say police!
Nonsense, I tell you. Now, if you would like to play Hugo the Troll, you're definitely in the right place. All you have to do is take part in our brilliant phoning competition if you have a touch tone phone. That is most important, OK? Here are the details of this week's prizes that you can go for. If you get a few points, fourth prize is... who are those guys? Or maybe girls, right? Modelling the CDs and cassettes. Third prize is the personal stereo. Who's that guy, more to the point? Second prize is the mountain bike. Nope, never seen him before either, but it's a good prize. And the big prize is the CD mini system. Now, when you do call and take part in Hugo the Troll, if you do want to play, whatever answer phone you get, just leave your name and your phone number and then you're in with a chance, okay? So just leave your name and phone number, you're in with a chance. What's the phone number, Michelle?
It is 0891 444488. That's 0891 444488.
Okay, that was beautifully done. Calls do cost 20p and please ask permission before you dial. I wish you luck with that. It's Nightmare Hair time. Here's Bugs Bunny on What's Up Dog.
Hiya. Well, I'm very excited because with me now is the new star of the brilliant new drama series Criss Cross, and it's Simon Fenton. Welcome to What's Up, Doc.
Thanks, Jeanette. It's good to be here.
Just a minute. When I watched Criss Cross last night, you had an American accent. What's happened to it?
Well, that's right, it's gone.
But it's back again?
It's back again.
Obviously, you're very good at accents. Do you find them easy to pick up?
Yeah, fairly easy. I've got a good ear for it, I suppose.
Yeah, and how about voices? Are you good on different picking up people's voices?
Oh, I don't know about that.
I'll give you a test. Balgit, go on, say something, test him.
No, I don't want to. Get on with the competitions, Jeanette. Get on with the competitions, Jeanette. Hey,
that's more like Balgit than Balgit, I do believe.
That was wonderful.
You'll be out of a job next. Oh, right, no. I'll get on with the competition. This week's phoning competition is to win this brilliant VHS video recorder.
Wow.
And the blank cassettes as well. That's coming up a little later on, details on how to win that. But right now, the phone lines are open to play Hugo the Troll. And if you get through to today's final, then you could be taking away one of these brilliant prizes. The fourth prize is a set of chart CDs. The third prize you can win is a nifty personal stereo. Not Andrew, unfortunately. The second prize is a brilliant mountain bike. And in first prize, it's the very clean CD mini hi-fi system. Some great prizes if you get through. Now, you're very good on accents, Sam, but are you any good on telephone numbers?
Let me see. It's 0891 44 44 88. That's 0891 44 44 88.
Brilliant in both accents as well. Right, Sam is going to be around to help me out all morning, which is good. So you just keep on watching What's Up, Doc?
Can you smell it, bro?
Yes, I can.
Spring is in the air.
It is.
Yes, it's time to turn over a new leaf.
Get lost? I couldn't do that.
Yes, you can. Come and turn over a new leaf.
I couldn't turn over a new leaf. Look, I'll try.
Oh, is that one?
This one. And this
oh,
and
missed
one.
It.
There's
one.
That,
another one.
Oh, let me
and
do one.
One over there.
Let me do one.
Look at that.
I want to do one.
New leaf.
Shut up, you. Oh. I done wrong.
You did wrong.
Welcome to our little leafy glade where spring has definitely sprung. It's certainly in this corner of the What's Up Doc studio. And welcome to Andy Holsworth, who is one of the... It says senior presenter on your badge.
Yes,
one of the keepers at London Zoo. Welcome to the programme. This is Dana. What kind of an animal is she?
Dana is a black and white ruffed lemur and... She originally was born in Norfolk. She's 4 years old.
Right, but in the wild, you can only find them in Madagascar, can't you?
That's right, yes. Madagascar's an island that broke off of Africa millions of years ago. And seeing as lemurs are very ancient animals, like living fossils, they broke away with the island, and the monkeys and the apes, which would compete with these animals, never made it.
Oh, right, so they got the island all to themselves because
well,
it broke
much.
Away. Now, you mentioned monkeys and apes. Are they like us? Do they have fingerprints like other primates and monkeys?
Yeah, if you look at her hands, you see, they're very human-like, her hands. She's got fingernails and fingerprints. Her toes are a bit like hands as well, so that she can climb. And here, can you see?
Yeah.
She's got toenails apart from that one, which is a toilet claw, which is good for scratching.
Oh, I see. So
that?
It gets into all those awkward little places.
That's right, yeah.
Okay. What's their natural habitat like, Andy?
Well, these lemurs live in the rainforest, but there are many, many different kinds of lemurs in the world. These ones that we're looking at now are black and white ruffed ring-tailed lemurs, sorry.
Right. Yeah.
And they are very at home in the trees, but these ones also come down to the ground sometimes. And as you can see them on the ground there, they've raised their tails up. Now, these black and white tails are very useful because they are used to keep the group together.
Right. Would Dana do the same thing with her tail? Would she use it as a marker?
Her tail's very long. It's not really a marker, it's used for balancing.
Right.
It's actually used for balancing.
What are the numbers like in the wild? Are they healthy, endangered?
Sadly, most lemurs in the wild are in danger. But they do breed very, very well in captivity. And one day, if the island is safe from the rainforest being destroyed, we will be able to reintroduce them to the wild.
Smashing. So what do you feed them on while you breed them in captivity?
She loves grapes, she loves apples, all kinds of fruits.
She likes banana as well.
She does like bananas.
She's got all them on my finger, so I can't go and get them. But we've got a banana down here for you, Dana. Now,
breakfast.
Yeah, look at that. She's smelt it already. It's incredible. We've got... Look, all right, she says, yes, I'd like to take it from me. There you... No, come on, you can have it. There you go. You enjoy yourself a bit of breakfast. She really gets into that, doesn't she? Now, we've split that open for her, but obviously she could do that herself in the wild.
Yeah, definitely. She loves bananas. Another thing she loves is sunbathing.
Really?
Yeah, she sunbathes when it's nice and sunny.
Right, and when she eats it, she tips her head back, doesn't she?
That's right.
So that all the juice goes down her throat. She doesn't waste a thing. Well, it's been a pleasure meeting you, and she's delightful. Thanks ever so much for bringing her in.
You're welcome.
Cheers.
Very welcome.
OK, it is your last chance now, your very last chance to take part in Hugo the Troll. If you have a touch-tone phone and you'd like to play, it is 20 pence. Please ask permission before you dial from Mum and Dad if they're still in bed. You go wake them up. It's 0891 444488, 0891 444488. Do it now and play Hugo the Troll. Please, you'll have such a ball, I promise you. What's going on here, then?
You see, Constable Chief Deputy Inspector, I put my keys down here, right, OK? Then I had my tea break, and when I turned back, they'd gone, vanished.
Oh, I see.
Oh, you're in big trouble. You know that thief? He can get into safes, offices, anywhere. You'll probably lose your job,
I know.
Calm down. We'll get to the bottom of this.
But hang on, it's not exactly crime at a century, is it? A bunch of keys.
Well, I forgot to tell you, Mr. Sharp, your dressing room keys were on the bunch as well.
Officer, it's essential you catch this hardened criminal immediately.
Oh, by the way, you're all suspects, so don't leave the studio.
Okay. Yeah, that's fair enough. Yeah, it wasn't me.
It wasn't me.
Well, coming up in part two of this show, we have last week's competition winners. You can win your own video recorder for your bedroom. Hugo the Troll, part one. It wasn't me. Sausage, take part later.
Absolutely. Details of how you could meet the band, go to Frankfurt in Germany, stay at a nice hotel and see the concert. But first, details of what's on the show this week.
Go, Jeanette.
Yes. At 9:50, heartthrob, Simon Fenton's back from the drama Crisscross.
That's only in 5 minutes' time. Fantastic. Animaniacs on at 10:10. La, la, la. 20 minutes of that, non-stop.
We've got Beautiful South singing for us. That's at 10:45 and 11:25.
Then Batman's favourite, Batman. What if Robin's in it today? The Worry Men will find out at 10 minutes to 11.
At 10 past 11, you've met her already. I'm going to be chatting to Michelle Gale and catching up on the old gossip.
Then we mentioned it. I'll take that competition. It's at 11:15 today. You must be tuned for it. It's the business.
And there's more Hugo the Troll. Hugo in Aeroplane World and the new Endgame. Brilliant.
Marvellous. It's his birthday this week, by the way. Happy birthday.
Do that again. Go on.
It's Luke Schofield's birthday this week, so happy birthday, Luke. Look at this.
There.
Last week on the programme, we had our NBA Jam competition. We were giving away loads of basketball goodies, including all this stuff down here, NBA Jam videos, computer games, CDs, shirts, and the rather nice basketball. The question was, how many teams are there in the NBA, which is the National Basketball Association? The answer is 27. We've got a bucket load of winners down here. Jeanette, can you pull out three winners for me, please?
Who
won? 27. So if you've got 27, you're in with a chance already.
Two.
Thank you. Okay. Simon Mayer from Milton Keynes is 12 years old and he's got 27. Well done, Simon.
Ross Burt, who's from Camford in Perthshire.
Yeah.
That's how you say it. And Sebastian Chung from Cheadle in Cheshire.
Oh, not well, Cheadle. Wow. Congratulations, you three. You'll all get NBA goodies courtesy of What's Up Doc.
Okay, remember when Jet was here last week? We had a brilliant Gladiators competition for you to name three events, any three events that take part in the Gladiators. There is the stirring music, and here is the brilliant winner. Now, this one wins because I've never seen anything quite as spectacular sent in. Have a look at this.
Wow.
Who do you think they are?
It must be Shadow.
Yeah. Another one? What do you want there?
I don't know. Wolf, maybe. Right.
That's Ulrika. There she is. Look. You can hardly see her head or shoulders. Anyway, it's a duel, which is fantastic here, and it's been sent in by Robin and Felicity in St Albans in Hearts. Congratulations to you. You had duel atmospheres and hang tough as your answers. So you are the big winners. You will go on Easter Monday with your family, up to four of you anyway, as long as you've got that bigger family, to see the big Gladiator show at Wembley Arena. But I need some runners up as well who are going to get all this gear. Have a look while I pick the runners up. We've got videos as well, which Robin and Felicity will get. And here's a couple more.
Do they get the cutout jet?
No, I'm afraid I'm keeping the cutout.
Oh, right.
It's become very close to me.
Yes, I suppose.
Chloe McBean is in Chislehurst in Kent. Well done. And also Benjamin Jacobs, age 6, at East Barnet in Hearts. You will get the runners-up gear. But Felicity, congratulations. That was brilliant, wasn't it, with Robert?
Excellent.
Now, last week, we had a Beethoven competition to win all these Beethoven goodies, the cuddly toy and the rucksack. And we had a question, which was, can you name the female St. Bernard that Beethoven fell in love with? And the answer was Missy. Like, come on, I pick some for the...
Oh, have I got to do the Beethoven?
What was the answer? One, two, three.
Sticking my tongue out there.
Who's won?
Who's won? Hang on a minute. Victoria Martin's won. She's in West Croydon in Surrey. Well done. And Miss Elmore Malin. Oh, double barreled. Oh, hello. From Catford in London. She wins as well.
I've got Cassie Valens from Fleet in Hampshire. Well done.
Smashing. Congratulations. Right, so the results of our Fair Play competition later on this morning. If you entered to be a Soccer Fair Play ambassador and go to the World Cup, find out later on if you're a winner. Also, the phone lines for Hugo the Troll are now closed, unfortunately. We've got the contestants we need. We'll speak to them later. They'll play Hugo in Aeroplane World a little later on. But that means the lines reopen immediately for our phone-in competition. And the prize this week is a doozer. We're giving away an Iowa VHS video recorder, remote control, a stack of tapes as well, so you can record What's Up Doc and enjoy Pat Sharp over and over again.
Heaven knows I do.
Yes. Yeah. Now, we need a competition question. Take That. We're giving away a prize to meet Take That in Germany. So how about... we use pounds and pence, but what currency do the Germans use?
What currency do the Germans use?
If you think you know, call us on this number. Balge?
Do you think you know? The number to dial is 0891 yes. 44 44 88. That's yes. 0891 44 44 88. It costs a mere 20 pence. But please, get permission first.
Excellent. I think Balge should win the prize now for getting the phone number
yes,
right.
Yes, absolutely.
Now, what are your... Weeks. Yes.
Don't forget about Rupert.
I was going to say...
New cartoon starts this week.
One of his favourite cartoons is coming back to CITV on Thursday. It starts at 10 minutes before 4 o'clock this coming Thursday. Have a little look now at Rupert the Bear and see what so fly away into his world. Listen, I wonder if Steve found his keys yet. What do you reckon? You got
the
signs?
Any clues yet about who stole my keys?
Look, I need to examine the scene of the crime first.
Yeah, of course you do. Yeah, I knew that, yeah.
Ah, that's interesting.
What?
There appear to be a number of hairs caught in the edge of the seat.
Where? Oh, yeah. Well, that proves it then, doesn't it, eh?
Proves what?
That the thief was hairy?
Maybe, maybe not. Now, it's vitally important we dust the scene of the crime for fingerprints. Right. Give us the brush, Steve, right. And open the jar.
Right.
You see, the answer to crime can often be staring you in the face. As long as you're careful, you won't have any...
God! Oh, sorry, Detective Chief Constable. Officer, I'll just dab you for dabs. Dab. It's very hot, isn't it?
Excellent. So, Simon Fenton is still with us. Here he is, looking good, feeling fine. Enjoying yourself?
Yeah, thanks.
OK, now, you were obviously watching last night, Criss Cross, the first
one.
If you weren't, let's have a little look now and see exactly what you missed out on last night, but you will be able to see next Friday on CITV. There he is, Simon Fenton, our guest today, the star of Criss Cross. Now, the first of six programmes there set at Stansfield Academy.
That's right.
What's it like there at that school if you were actually there in real life? How would you say it's
good? Well, I don't think I'd like to be there myself.
No?
It's a pretty stuffy school. Teachers are horrible.
Really?
Food is absolutely terrible.
Oh, dear.
I think the best thing about the school is that they've just brought in girls.
Oh, that's good. So, with your American accent, are you a big hip with the gals?
Well, we've done two series so far, and not a hint of any so far.
But it's shown in America, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
And you're really popular in the States already.
Yep.
OK. Did you have to audition against real American actors for your part? I want you to do this in American answer, so just to see if you can get into it. Go
OK, on. Here we go. OK. Well, it was kind of an open audition, so they didn't really know what they wanted, so... I went in there like this and got
it. That's really good, the way you can just turn it on like that. We'll say, have a nice day, and are you having a good time? What's up? You've worked with lots of American stars, like John Goodman and people like that, who's the new Fred Flintstone, isn't he?
That's right, yeah.
And you worked in Florida for 3 months on a film? What film was that?
That was a film called Matinee. It was good. We spent about 3 weeks in the Florida Keys and the rest of the time in Orlando.
So, yeah, packed in a lot into your 17 years.
Certainly have.
Fancy a bit more Hollywood?
I wouldn't mind, yeah.
Good, OK. Well, I hope that Criss Cross is a huge success. I'll definitely be watching next Friday. And you stick around with us this morning.
I will do.
OK, without a doubt. Simon Fenton is right here on What's Up, Doc. We've got the most brilliant Take That competition coming up pretty soon as well, so hang on for that.
How strange. Hello, children. I'm here today to talk to you about the sun.
Yeah!
It was sunny in the week, wasn't it? Did you humans enjoy that? Of course you did.
Yeah!
The minute the sun shines, humans rush out, buy ice creams, buy T-shirts, pull on the jeans, buy your new clothes. What are you like? You fashion victims. Bro. What are you playing at?
Yeah, I'm just trying to get these jeans on. They're a bit tight.
Well, come on, I'm with you. Pull them on. Can you do it? It's not the winning, it's the taking part, isn't it?
Hiya, Michael. I'm with Michael Duffy here. He's our fashion expert. And we're talking hats today, aren't we?
One of my
favourite baseball hats. I love these, but look at all these colourful things you've done with them. Tell me about it.
Well, baseball hats are brilliant because most people have them and sometimes you get them given as freebies at garages and things.
Yeah.
And you just need to customise them. I've used various different things like paint, motifs, even tin foil.
Right, I love the cheeky way when they're wearing to the
exactly.
side like this.
That's the good thing. You can wear them front ways or back ways like here or even to the side.
Get your hands off! Do you know we have trouble with these wolves? Now, these are obviously specially for What's Up.
Yes, I did them specially for this morning.
They're brilliant. I like those. I think I could fancy one of those myself. Are they easy to make?
Well, they are, actually. I'll show you how to make a Bugs Bunny one later on.
Oh, good, good. Get off! Right, moving quickly on. These remind me of the Cool Runnings hats I had as a competition prize a few weeks ago. But you can't make these unless you're a good knitter.
No, you can. You don't even have to sew with these. These are just made out of old jumpers, just sleeves out of old jumpers.
What a
very
good
easy.
Idea. And these bandanas, have you painted these yourself?
Yeah, I have. I mean, the good thing is all I used here was just old handkerchiefs and fabric paint and pen, and they're good for summer.
I suppose you need to use a special paint, because otherwise, if it rains or you sweat, it can just come
exactly.
off.
Don't use normal felt tip. It's fabric paint and pen you can get from any department store. It won't come off in the wash.
Right, brilliant. And these, I'm sorry, I know you've got one on, but they do make me laugh. They do make me laugh a lot. Are these easy to make as well?
Yes, they are. I mean, as I say, they're just made out of leggings. Like, here, if you can come over here, I'll just show you how to make one.
Yes, well, go on.
Right. Just a pair of leggings I got from a jumble sale, 10p.
Yes. Yeah, you have to make sure. I mean, when I was about 5, I remember cutting up one of my best dresses to make dolls' outfits. My mum wasn't very pleased with me for a while, so make sure you've either got them from a jumble sale or don't go in your big sister's bedroom and nick all her best clothes. Doesn't do. You'll be in trouble.
All you do to finish it off, there's no sewing, you just get an old shoelace.
Yes.
And there you have it.
Brilliant. As easy as that. You get an outfit and you think, I need a hat. Look at that. In a jiffy. Now, this is the one I'm interested in.
Yeah, this is like the Hugo one that I made earlier. This is going to be Bugs Bunny. This is how it started, just a plain white cap. I've already done half of this. Painted the top grey with fabric paint. And the eyes, what I've done here, I've done them separately on some felt you can just get from the department store really easy. I've just used fabric pen to draw the eye in. Right, what you do is you cut it out. You can use double-sided sticky tape or glue. And that sticks on like that.
So I suppose you could do any
design
character
you want.
Or whatever
for
you want.
The ears, that's just foam. Very easy, you can get hold of that anywhere. Just use the paper pattern, lay that down, cut it out, and to affix it to the hat, all you do is you cut a slit in the top of it.
Brilliant.
And
well,
are
the details of all these on the fact sheet?
Yeah, they are.
Which I will be giving details of later.
They are, so...
How are you doing on that?
There you go, that's done there. And finishing touch.
Oh.
Use foam with a fake nose.
Right.
You just stick that there with double-sided sticky tape.
Right.
And that's done. If you'd like
Brilliant.
To try it on, that's your Bugs Bunny
would.
What's Up Doc hat.
And I've got a mirror here to see what I look like. How do I look?
Fantastic.
Rather silly. Oh, well, never mind. It's Hugo the Troll now.
Do we want our honest opinion of what she looks like? And they're so excited, eh? We've got a rowdy bunch in today. They saw the camera arrive and they were like, oh, we're going to be on the telly. What's your favourite computer game? Everybody's favourite computer game. They all want to play it. We've had so many calls this morning, but our first contestant this week is from Liverpool, but he's still got his health. Sorry, it's just a thing about Mancunians that we're at the wrong end of the M62. Anthony, hello.
Hello.
How are you?
Fine.
Anthony Miller from Liverpool. Are you a red or a blue, Anthony?
I'm a red.
You're hesitant, not really a football fan?
No.
Nah. What do you do in your spare time, Anthony?
Play the computer.
Play the computer. What system do you have?
Amiga 1200.
Ooh. Are you a Take That fan by any chance?
No.
No, you're not. I just wondered. Because we've got an amazing Take That competition coming up later on. I thought, well, the guys might want to enter as well as the girls. You're more interested in winning big prizes on Hugo the Troll, though, I would have thought.
Yeah.
Right, these are the prizes that are up for grabs this week. Anthony, fourth prize, 5 chart cassettes and CDs, but not Jeanette Beverly. Third prize, personal stereo. I can pop down the M62 and deliver it, I suppose. Second prize is the mountain bike. And top of the heap, if it stays in the studio long enough. Hey, bring that back. It's our CD mini hi-fi system, which is rather nice and can be yours. Consolation prizes, if you don't get through to the end game or if you're not the winner, we get the Hugo goodie pack, which includes the floor manager's hand. Sandra's hand. And the pen. And the watch. And the sweatshirt and the T-shirt and all the other bits and pieces. But not the rather nice ring that Sandra was wearing that you saw there. Sadly, that is not one of the consolation prizes. Right, let's interface with your phone, Anthony. Press 5, please. Not long enough? Yeah, we've got you. OK, we'll play Hugo the Troll in Aeroplane World after we've told you the object of the exercise.
Hugo, get going. You've got to get us out of here. You will never be free. Hugo can't beat me. I'm watching you. Hugo's little helper.
I just noticed, because normally your eyes, watch the thing, if Hugolina goes like that,
when she scratches the screen in the background. Never noticed that before. In Hugo and Aeroplane World, Anthony, 4 will move him to the left, 6 will move him to the right. The biggest tip I can give you, and this is most important, press naught and have a look at the map and figure out where you're going, because to get to the end game, it doesn't matter how many bags of gold you've got, you must get over the mountain in roughly a straight line. 4 and 6, about the same number of times, will keep Hugo in a straight line. Stay away from the thunderclouds, stay away from the red balloons, but do keep checking the map. Don't hold naught down to check the map, just press it once. It'll pause the game. You won't crash the plane. Press naught again to bring the game back. OK, understand all that?
OK.
OK, let's play Hugo the Troll.
Start the propeller, fella.
Naught to start the propeller, please, Anthony. Off we go.
Whee!
Fingers crossed for Anthony Miller from Liverpool. That's 2 straight away, dead easy there. 1, 2, oh, he's got the idea. Quick off to the left. That's the way, oh, we've got a... That's good. There's a blue one there. Yeah, it's all right, we have to be quick. Oh, unfortunately, you didn't manage it. You lose a life there, but it's not all over. It's only really bad if you run out of fuel, because that's the end of the game. Hugo plummets earthwards, but manages to save himself, which is rather nice.
That really brought me down to earth.
Come on, Hugo.
Delay. I'm ready to play.
I miss the gaps every time. Off we go then, Anthony. Remember, check the map, figure out where you are. OK, that's pretty good, but a bear off to the right a little bit, I think. Nought will bring the game back. There we go. At the end of the day, gold bags are all very well, but if you don't get over the mountain, you don't play the end game for big prizes. Oh, nice. That was a super gold bag. That'll be an extra 10,000. Collect that one. I would suggest another look at the map now, mate, just to make sure where you are. Yeah, you're going off to the left a bit. Bring around to the right, or else you'll run out of fuel. Nought to start the game again. That's the way. You've got a good number of bags now, so I'd concentrate on getting over the mountain. Yeah, that's the way. Anthony's got the idea. Keep checking where you are. Nought will bring the game back. Keep checking where you are. Fuel's getting a bit low, so right is the order of the day to get over the mountain, mate. Come on, don't run out of fuel on me, Anthony. Don't let me down now. You've got a good score. Veer off to the right. Nought will bring it back. That's the way. Right. You're on your last legs of fuel here, but I think you should be all right. Right. Bit more right. Ooh, yes! By gum, you were on your last legs there.
Hey, we made it. Well done.
Congratulations, Anthony. Let's have a look at your final score just to figure out what you got. You got 55,000 worth of gold bags. You had 1 life left, I think, which is another 5,000 bonus, which is good. You hit 1 balloon, so lose 3. 1 super gold bag, I heard 10,000, which means Anthony Miller from Liverpool, your final score is 67,000 points! Brilliant! Well done, Anthony. For goodness sake, don't go out. I think you're in the running for some big prizes, unless our second contestant does better still. Find out when we play Hugo again later.
OK.
Oh, it's your French lieutenant's woman.
Oh, no. What is the Boy Scout? Choppy.
What you doing in there?
Get out of my dream.
Where you go?
Little biggie. It's a quad boy. It's a big choppy. Oh, big choppy. Oh, you good children.
Get out of my dream.
Hello, bro. Having a bad dream? What's all that about?
Dreamers, eh? Who needs them? So, if you want to win this VHS, all you have to do is call 08...
Sorry about this, Mr. Sharp. Routine procedure.
I'm trying to do
just need to compare the sample found at the scene of the crime with your hair.
Excuse me? What are you...
You're in the clear. Blonde hair.
So I was trying to say, and if you want to win this brilliant prize on this show, all you have to do is... Well, we've got to take that competition coming later, OK? Where you can meet and greet them in Germany. So we've come up with a sort of Germany-related question. What is the currency that Germans use? In other words, the money. We use pounds and pence and all that. What do they use in Germany, OK? So please make sure you take part in this now and give us a call. The phone number is, as I was trying to say...
Oh, not much of it.
Well, it's gone.
Can't have been you.
Well, I'm hardly going to go around stealing my own keys, am I?
Am I?
Fauci, when you did a phone number, then we're trying to do this.
The phone number is 0891 444488. 0891 444488. Calls cost a mere 20 pence, but please get permission.
This is interesting.
What is?
Your hair is very similar to the sample, Mr. Balgi.
What?
Can you explain yourself?
What?
Well, there must be a sample.
Balgi!
No, really, it wasn't me.
Animaniacs will save us from all this trouble, so I'm sure I can sort it out with the
officer,
okay?
It wasn't me!
Balgi! What's up, Doc? Continues live on a Saturday morning. Twins, you don't know anything about these stolen keys, do you at all? No, because I'm rather worried about Steve. You see, he'll lose his job if they don't turn up. Yeah. Very strange indeed. Animaniacs is on next. It's rather good. We better call LA Law, quick.
Come out again in the afternoons on CITV this next week. Should we do it again, then? Oh, go on, you do it again. What's your favourite computer game? They love it, because they want to be on telly, you see. Yep, time to play round two of Hugo the Troll. Now, our contestant's got... fair act to follow, because Anthony Miller from Liverpool, our round one contestant, scored 55,000 points in gold bags, 5,000 left for one life, lost 3,000 for hitting one red balloon, and got 10,000 for a super gold bag, giving me a grand total of 67,000 points, and he got across the mountain, which means Leanne Walker. Hello, Leanne.
Hello.
Hi, you're in Barrow-in-Furness, aren't you?
Yeah.
You've got your work cut out. Did you see Anthony perform?
Yeah.
He did very well, didn't he? He cut it very fine, though. Like I said, he had it sussed. The thing to do is to keep checking the map just to figure out where you are. He came that close to running out of fuel, which would have meant the end of the game for him, but he managed it. So time is against us, so we'll have to press on. Let's interface with your phone, Leanne. Can you press 5 for me? Yeah, we've got that there. OK, I'll remind you that in Hugo in aeroplane world, 4 on your phone will move the plane to the left, 6 will move him to the right. To check the map, you just press 0. The game will pause. You won't crash, that's OK. Check where you are over the mountain. Press 0 to start the game again. Stay away from the red balloons. Stay away from the thunderclouds. And for goodness sake, don't run out of fuel, because that will be it. Kaput, finito. 67,000 to beat if you want to play the end game for big prizes later. But before we do that, don't forget this bit. Watch Hugolina's eyes when she scratches the screen, because I only spotted this week. Here's who you've got to save.
Hugo, get going. You've got to get us out of here. You will never be free. Hugo can't beat me. I'm watching you. Hugo's little...
Now watch your eyes. She's like, oh! I never noticed that before. It's very funny. Oh, my. Oh, dear. Yes! Oh, no! What's that film called? Alive. Is that the one? Yes.
Don't do it, Mr. Crane.
Yes, all right. Thank you very much. There's our little representation of it in 5 seconds or less. Right, are you ready, Leanne?
Yep.
OK. Press... Oh, no, we'll play Hugo the Troll.
Start the propeller, fella.
Now press 0 to start the propeller, please. And away we go.
Whee!
Keep that plane in a straight line and stay away from those thunderclouds and red balloons. There's... Oh, she went straight away from 2 good ones there. Just little presses are all you need. Oh, dear, not a particularly good start, unfortunately, Anne, but never mind. Little presses are the other day, just did not great big holds. OK, Hugo, how are you?
That really brought me down to earth.
Yeah, it did. Unfortunately, you haven't got off the mark yet, Leanne.
Don't
still
delay.
Naught.
I'm ready to play.
One day I'll get the gaps in this game. Right, OK, here we go. Let's get some points on the board if we can. OK, off to the right, perhaps. There's one. There's 5,000 euro. Oh, dear, oh, dear, oh, dear. Straight into a thundercloud, which means you destroy the plane and he plummets earthwards.
Have no fear. What luck to land here.
Indeed, what luck to land here.
Hello. One life to go.
One life left, Leanne. One life left. Left, that's good. To right would have been good there. That's it. Going off to the right. All right. You might want to check the map just to see where you are. That was a super gold bag. That's 10,000. Oh, you're on track. That's okay. Okay, naught again will start the game. Got yourself another one. You got a super gold bag. Oh, that was unfortunately a bad bag, which is lose 10,000. They're completely random. There's another 5. You're doing okay. Now you've got the idea. She's got her eye in now, as you might say, or your hand in, I suppose. Oh, quick, 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 quick. But by gum, you got away with that. You just winged it there. Just clipped that red balloon and you got away with it. Check where you are, I think, Leanne. Have a quick look at the map. Yeah, you've gone off to the... Oh, you're in a straight line, though, so that's OK. You trek left a bit. Nort will start the game again. Straight up. Running out of fuel, but if you get... You might get... Just clipped a thunderclad. You're really flying by the seat of your pants. Well done, you got to the end game. But I don't think you're going to beat 67. I'll just let Hugo go down.
Well done.
Congratulations, that's two people through to the end game, which is better than last week. Let's have a look at your final score, Leanne. 40,000 for gold bags. No lives left, so no bonus. You've got Thundercloud minus two, a red balloon minus three is minus five, a super lose 10 for a bad bag, which means your final score is 25,000 points. Unfortunately, you are not going to be playing the end game for big prizes with me, but you got across the mountain, which is more than most people have done, and we will send you the nice Hugo consolation pack, which will include the backpack and the sweatshirt, the T-shirt, the poster, the pen, the pad, and the nice watch and pen set. Do you enjoy playing the game?
Yep.
OK, well, thank you, Leanne. Nice to talk to you. And Anthony, you and I are playing Hugo the Troll final later on for big prizes, so don't go out. Oh, no!
Oh, hard luck, Leanne. You did better than I did yesterday. I think I got 5,000 or something. I was rubbish. Anyway, back with me again is Michael Duffy, and we have a very special What's Up Doc Easter fashion parade. Take it away, folks. Whoa!
The first model is Mark, and he's looking very fluffy in my Easter chick sun visor.
Very colourful.
Next, we have Gemma, and she's wearing a more traditional style Easter bonnet. It's a nest complete with eggs and chicks. Yay! And this is Peter, and he's wearing an Easter egg box tower. This is a very environmentally friendly hat because you can make it out of your old rubbish.
Right.
And last but not least, we have Hannah wearing a huge cracked egg. She's hatched a load of yellow feathers.
Brilliant. Well, that was excellent, and you all look like professional models. Shall we take a closer
look?
I love this. It's so colourful, and you see, you can wind people up all night by tickling them in the face. You see, I like that one. But this, I have to say, is my favourite, because you get to eat all the chocolate, don't you?
You certainly do.
Excuse me, wasn't that full when you put that on? Wasn't that full of chocolate?
No.
Did you eat it?
No.
Are you sure?
Actually, it was me that I ate it all.
Oh, right. Well, I'm surprised you weren't ill. Moving swiftly on. I like this. Is it very heavy?
No, because actually that's made out of papier-mâché and just a balloon. If you'd like to speak to her, I'm sure she's got something to say about it.
Is it heavy? How are you finding it? Is it comfortable?
Fine, yes.
Oh, good. Good. I think it's rather extravagant.
I'll give her the £5 later.
And this one. I love this one. I mean, is this rather cheap to make?
Yes, I mean, it's just made up of twigs that you can pick up in the park.
Yeah. How do you feel wearing it? Do you feel rather silly?
No, not really.
I should hope not.
Of course she
doesn't. Very good, and you're a little whittle there at the end as you were coming down. I thought that was rather good. Right, if you want to know how you can make any of these Easter bonnets or any of the hats we had earlier, then we have a fact sheet. If you want that, you write to us at this address. Get ahead, fact sheet. What's up, Doc? P.O. Box 1, Maidstone, Kent, ME14 5LL. That's Get Ahead, fact sheet. What's up, Doc? P.O. Box 1, Maidstone, Kent, ME14 5LL. Well, thanks for coming
so
and showing
me along. So, you did it yet?
I have my suspicions.
Yeah, well, I think all these clues are leading us up a blinder.
Steve, I'm trying to do a fashion show here.
Sorry,
really?
What's keeping her then, eh?
I don't know.
So what? You ready to play this game of conkers then, boys?
Yeah, thought you'd bottled out.
Oh, let's no, not me.
Let's see your conker. Let's see your conker.
Yeah. Look at this one.
Look at the size of that.
You haven't seen our old conquering conker yet, have you?
No, let's see.
Let's have it.
OK, here we go.
Get him out.
Oh, that's not a conker.
Hey, dumbbell, stop. Steady, steady.
Don't worry, don't worry.
Here we go, then. After three, eat the conker. Eat the
conker. No,
conker. Enough of that.
Just stop it.
Who started it?
She started it.
She started it.
It was you, don't lie.
You're going to come quietly?
I'm innocent.
Oh no! Why the wrong one?
All right.
Who did that?
It was him.
It was him.
It was you. You banked to rights.
Yes, thank you.
Please, no! All the best prizes on What's Up Doc. You will remember a couple of weeks ago we offered you a chance to go to the World Cup to be a Snickers Fair Play ambassador.
and lead the teams out at the New York Giants Stadium in front of a worldwide audience of, like, millions and millions of people. We asked you for a full-length photo of yourself in your footy kit and 100 words as to why you should be the Fair Play Ambassador. Who's won? Jeanette knows.
I have the answer. It's Benjamin Vigisi, who is 13. He comes from Bognor Regis in West Sussex.
There he
and
is.
He writes, yes, there's a good picture of him. He writes, one of my earliest football memories is Diego Maradona's handball. I was disgusted. I think that all footballers, from school children to full internationals, should get through their career without a single red or yellow card. Even if I can't be FIFA's ambassador for fair play, I'm determined to always try to encourage fair play whenever I play football. Have you got his number yet?
Yeah, I've got it. Hang on.
Great.
He's in. We're gonna talk to him. What's his name? Benjamin.
This music makes me fall asleep, yeah. You know.
Hello.
Hello.
Is Benjamin there?
Yep.
Hello, Benjamin. You're a winner on What's Up, Doc.
Yeah.
He's pleased, isn't he?
Yeah.
He's excited.
Well
there
done.
He is. A Manchester United fan by the look of that kit, yes?
Yep.
Good news. Well, you are going to the World Cup in July, courtesy of What's Up, Doc. Details of that fabulous prize come later. But more importantly, are you busy Monday?
No.
No, because, well, we want to take you to Arsenal's ground, Highbury, with Pat and myself, to do some footy training with the England goalkeeper, David Seaman. What do you reckon?
Wow.
Marvellous. Right, so get your boots, get your kit. We'll see you at Highbury on Monday. OK, mate?
Yep.
Congratulations, Benjamin. Bye-bye.
Bye.
There's another winner on What's Up, Doc, which is marvellous. And, ow, oh.
Ow, what did you do that for?
Just eliminating you from my inquiries.
Yeah, right. Thank you very much indeed. After the break, we're back with Batman. Pat will be talking to the beautiful South. So stick with the winning team on What's Up, Doc.
What's Up, Doc continues with Jackie, Paul and Dave from the House Minds and the rest of the gang here. It used to be the House Minds, should I say, but are now the beautiful South. That was my first line, because that's true, isn't it?
What?
You were the House Minds.
I was.
You yeah. was, yeah. And just you got together with all your mates.
And formed a different band.
The beautiful South.
Yeah.
And now here you are. Now, Jackie is the newest member, so how did you get in the band then?
Just met up with Paul.
Yeah. But there's a good story behind how you got singing at a party. Come on, give
us
that story.
It was just me. Met him at a party and was all on about music and he sang and I sang and then... I guess from there. I didn't think anything of it after that, and then he got in touch with me after Brenna left. So
really, so what was your move on that? I mean, was there a planned changeover of female vocalist?
No, not really. No, Brenna left, and I got in touch with a friend of mine, Andy from St Helens, and said, "Do you remember this certain girl who was singing at a party?" And he remembered who it was, and went to a mini market or wherever you're working and asked her. Supermarket. So I always call it a mini market. Don't
right. And your dream came true. Tell us about the new album as well. What do you mean, well? Your dream did come true.
That's
yeah, that's right. Dave, the new album, quick.
Meow, it's gold, 28th of March, it's out, and it's really good.
Well, you've been as good as gold, so thanks for coming. Beautiful South are on. What's up, Doc? Enjoy this. Good song.
South, more than that, and a little later on.
I'm worried, Andy.
What?
Well, Steve might lose his job over those missing keys, and they suspect me too.
Yeah, everybody's under suspicion, mate. You worry too much. Aww. Coincidentally, Batman this week is called the Worry
Batman?
Man. And take that, fan, stick around. The competition details next.
Batman!
What's that?
What are you saying?
There goes the budget. Hey, do you fancy a game of frisbee?
That'd be a good idea, wouldn't it?
A good idea.
How about a game of frizz-ball?
Good idea.
Bouge it!
Oh, yeah. Legless!
What?
Crouch down. That'll do. Look at that. Look at that view.
It's flattened out nice.
I'll go over here. I'll go over here.
Ready? Hold on.
Ready?
Shut up now. Skim tight!
Oh! Can you believe it? I caught it. That's amazing. That
was always a surprise.
Oh, not that way! Not that
what are you
way.
Doing, you clown?
Where's it gone?
Oh, no. Right. What? I'm confiscating that.
Oh, no. What have you done, you fool?
Right, you're going to come quietly this time.
Are you going to come quietly?
What do you mean?
Have you ever seen Alien?
Yeah.
I'll leave it at that, shall we?
John Hurt!
I hope that didn't hurt, Baltic. I hope you're all right. Very nice, is it? I'm here now with Michelle. How are you doing? Are you all right?
I'm fine, thank you.
Are you enjoying yourself?
Yes, it's wicked.
Great. Now, what I want to know is, you've been coming in and out of EastEnders for a while. Have you left for good this time?
Well, it's still very open, but I am out of contract and,
But never say never. You
can't say
never.
That's
you
right.
haven't died in it, so
no,
there's always
exactly.
chance of you
always,
going
always
back.
Always
now, not only are you an ace actress, but you're a fabulous singer
Thank
as well.
You.
Which do you enjoy doing most, the acting or the singing?
I like both. Right now, I'm concentrating on singing because I've done concentrating on acting for like 3 years on EastEnders, so I thought I'll spend some time on my singing.
Is it quite hard to make that changeover for people to accept you as a singer as opposed to an actress?
Initially, it was before people heard the single, but when people heard the single, they were really
quite
nice,
rightly
really
so.
Kind.
Yes. Oh, she can sing after all, they said. Right. Now you had a debut single out last summer, mm-hmm. which was called Looking Up. We've got a video, so let's take a look at a clip. Oh, we didn't see enough of that, did we? I love that. Well
Thank
done.
Thank you.
Right. The audience have been dying to ask questions all morning to you. So, Jade, whereabouts is Jade? Have you
here
got
she is. She's over here. Go ahead. Go on.
If you could choose any location for a video, where would it be?
Oh, great question, Jade. I'll say if you're listening, Jamaica, please, Jamaica.
Not the East End or anywhere like that.
No,
Jamaica.
Jamaica.
Right.
It's got to be
Who
Jamaica.
Have we got next? Whereabouts is Jeffrey?
He's up here, I think.
Oh.
From what I remember. Go ahead, Jeff.
What sort of music do you listen to at home?
Right now I'm listening to a lot of Snoop Doggy Dogg. That's what? A rap album.
Woo!
Very good, Pat.
He's yeah. not bad.
Like soul
makes a good
stuff.
Dog. And anyway, and I like a lot of R&B, a lot yeah. of soul music.
Are you a person of moods? I am. I sort of listen
yeah,
to
I'm
one
very,
thing.
Yeah, I'm very. Yeah, I have to be in a certain frame of mind. Sometimes yes. I listen to jazz or Sting or, you know, it
Great.
Changes.
One more question, Emma. Whereabouts? Oh, right here.
Are you allowed to choose what you wear for videos and Top of the Pops?
It's very much a collaboration, Emma. There's someone called the stylist, and she'll have suggestions of what she wants you to wear. But if you don't like it, you don't have to wear it. And I often don't wear it. I'm like, no, I'm not wearing that.
Now, have you got a new single coming out soon?
Yes, it's due out right in the beginning of May.
Oh, good. I'll yes. look forward to that. I enjoyed
and
your last
the
one.
Album will be out later on.
Well, it's been
well.
Absolutely brilliant chatting to you. I've enjoyed yeah. catching up on the gossip. Now, the thing you've all been waiting for, coming up right now with Andy, is the brilliant, mega Take That competition!
Oh, please, thank you, yes. There we go, what a nice lady Michelle is. OK, how do you fancy going to a Take That concert? Okay, what do you say, yeah? How do you fancy? You'll not get a competition like this anywhere else. We'll take you to Germany, you'll meet the band, you'll see the concert, you'll stay in a rather nice hotel. I'm coming as well, but don't let that put you off. Some requirements first, before we tell you what you have to do. Please don't enter unless you can meet all these requirements, because obviously we're going to be inundated. So we'd like to think that everybody who enters can fulfil these requirements. You must be available to fly on Tuesday the 29th of March. Now, it's only 10 days away, so make sure you can fly early Tuesday the 29th of March. You'll come back early the Wednesday morning, so you'll have to be able to get the day off school. You must get permission for that. You must have a passport, obviously, because we're going to Germany. And you must have a parent or guardian who's prepared to come with you. We can't take you on your own, because it's against the law. So a parent or guardian must have a passport, must be available to fly on the 29th of March and come back on the morning of Wednesday the 30th.
I'll go.
If you can fulfil all those requirements, then this is what you have to do. This is the current single from Take That. Everything changes. It's a smashing-looking CD, I'm sure you'll agree. But it's not the most creative CD you've ever seen, have you?
Yeah.
What do you think? What we want you to do is design a CD for Take That. Now, there's some examples of other band stuff down here. As Wright said, Fred there. And that's beautiful, the most beautiful girl in the world. This is our CDs are looking more and more funky these days. And what we'd like you to do is design a CD for Take That. So you can take the theme of Everything Changes, or you can take the theme of the band, whatever you like. Best thing to do, get a piece of paper, draw around your CD like that, and then put your design in the middle. When you've thought of it, and think of it quickly, because the closing date is Thursday the 24th,
not
obviously we're taking on the 29th. When you've done that, put your name, your age, please, your address, your phone number, and the name of the parent or guardian who will accompany you to Germany, and send it to this address, Balge.
Take That to Germany competition. What's up, Doc? P.O. Box 1, Maidstone, Kent, ME14-5LL.
Smashing. Get them in by Thursday the 24th, please. We'll announce the results next week, and you'll be flying the following Tuesday. And
good
I'm coming
luck.
To it's going to be absolutely brilliant. But right, back to this week, our phone-in prize. We're giving away this video recorder, remote control with a stack of tapes. It's your last chance to call. We're going to Germany to meet Take That. We want to know what money do they use in Germany? What currency? If you know, 0891-444-888, 0891-444-888. The call will cost you a minimum of 20p, so please get permission before you dial. Coming up after the break, we've got more from the beautiful South, and we play the Hugo the Troll final with Anthony.
Yeah!
Yes, live!
Dave, What's Up Doc continues, and Michelle is still with us. I'm sorry it's a bit chaotic. Some keys were stolen.
That's OK, Pat, I'll let you off.
Still having a good time, aren't you?
Yeah, it's wicked.
And you like Alison Moyet?
Yeah, she's all right.
Well, it just happens me and my good buddy here have her video. It's called Whispering Your Name, so we'll do it together. Alison Moyet.
And that's Whispering Your Name, and a very nice song it is too. Our Hugo winner this week, Anthony Miller from Liverpool, got himself 67,000 points. Hello, Anthony.
Hello.
Are you all right?
Yep.
Yep, fine, good. You're excited?
Yeah.
Big prizes up for grabs, Anthony. I'll show you what they are and the number of points you will need to win them. It is as follows. Fourth prize, the chart cassettes and CDs. You'll need 40,000 to 80,000 points. For the third prize, which is the personal stereo, 81,000 to 130,000. For the second prize, which is the mountain bike, right, he says, right, 131,000 to 200,000. And the top prize is the personal, is the stereo. CE hi-fi system, state-of-the-art, 201 to 280,000. And I've just done some sums, and you've got 67,000, and 3 times 67 is 201. So if you get the right key in the end game, you will win the CD hi-fi system, state-of-the-art remote control. Did you see Keys played last week, Anthony? Did you see the game last week, the keys, the end game?
No.
I'll explain it to you. This is how it works. Hugo is stood by a treasure chest. There is a keyhole in that treasure chest. You will have time to look at the keyhole. Then three keys will appear. They will rotate for 5 seconds. Look very carefully at the end of the keys, because you've got to figure out which key will open the treasure chest. Then an egg timer will appear. The egg timer will turn over. You will have the time it takes the sand to run out of the egg timer to make your choice. I will say from now when you can choose. Don't press anything till I say now. But basically, take a good look at the keyhole, take a good look at the ends of the keys and see whether it's one, two or three that will open the treasure chest. If you get the right one, it'll triple your points, you'll get the CD system. If it doesn't, we'll see. OK, you ready?
OK.
Best of luck. We've got everything crossed for you. Let's play the Hugo Endgame.
Thank you.
You've done well so far. But now
look at that
you need
keyhole,
the key
Anthony.
To grab the gold and set them free.
Now look at them carefully. Don't press anything yet. Anthony, make your selection now. Anthony selected number one. Will it open the treasure chest? Yes! Yes! System, but better than that, you've released Hugolina and the kids.
Yes,
it's happily ever after in Hugo Land. Hugolina and the kids are saved. There they are, 201,000 points. Anthony, you've won the CD Hi-Fi system! Well done, mate. That's coming to you, courtesy of WhatsApp Doc, in a very large WhatsApp Doc lumpy parcel. Are you chuffed or what?
Yeah.
Absolutely thrilled. That'll look brilliant in your bedroom. Congratulations. Nice to talk to you. Well done playing the game. If you want to win a prize like this, watch WhatsApp Doc 9:25 sharp.
Now, this is a classic case of theft. Mm-hmm. And what we have to ask ourselves is, why was what was stolen, stolen?
Yeah.
Steve.
Could you repeat the question, please?
Now, you all assume that the keys are in the wrong hands.
Yeah.
That is, in fact, not the case.
What?
I don't get it.
I found these hairs.
We, you and me, we, together.
We found these hairs at the scene of the crime and discovered that they looked like Belgians.
Oh, boy, 20 years in the slammer.
But, in fact, they are shorter than Belgians.
Freedom!
It was the twins who stole the keys.
What?
To play with, nothing more. OK, twins, game's up. Let's have the keys.
Oh, honestly, twins, you nearly got me sacked. Of course, I blame the parents when this sort of thing happens.
Do you know, so do I.
Yeah, so do I.
Eh?
What?
Another case. Yeah. Cracked.
Welcome to the Jolly Holiday Programme. We've just spent a week in Tenerife. And what we liked about the place was...
Can we start again?
Sorry, that's terrible. Oh. Welcome to the Jolly Holiday Programme. We've just spent a week in Tenerife. And what we didn't like about the place was... And what we did like about the place was... Closer to home, Penny spent a short while in Bournemouth. And what she couldn't help but notice was... This is where we're sending you this week, Matthew.
flight from Malaga is leaving from gate 6.
Well, anyway, our advice to anyone contemplating some foreign travel is don't bother. You're better off staying in good old Blighty and letting friends and distant relatives visit you. Goodbye!
Goodbye!
Hello!
Goodbye!
Is this like a nice place? I could stay here and walk.
Yes.
A week?
Yes, that's what I'm trying to say. Tough language, isn't it, please?
The answer to the phoning question was Deutschmarks, Marks or Phoenix. Who's won the video,
Martin Jeanette? Brown from Chesterfield.
Well done.
Congratulations. Brilliant. Thank you, Simon. Thank you, Michelle.
Thank
Couldn't
you.
Keep it all in. Have a nice weekend. It's the beautiful South.
Bye-bye. Here, I found the ketchup.
Well, it's a bit late now, isn't it?